Since the dawn of harmonica history, which is quite a bit less than 200 years, people have been making harmonicas of all sizes, shapes, and assembly types. The main one is to have, certainly for a diatonic harmonica, is to have a reed plate on the top with the blow reeds, a reed plate on the bottom with the draw reeds. And this is the overwhelmingly dominant assembly type available today. The trouble with that is that, if one reed goes on a typical diatonic harmonica, you've got 20 reeds. If one reed breaks or goes flat, unless you have the skills to replace that reed by, disassembling the harmonica, punching out the reed, putting a new individual reed in the slot, it's quite a skilled operation. Unless you have those skills, your only options are to either throw the harmonica away altogether and get it, buy a new one, or with a few models, you can actually buy just the two reed plates. Either way, it's pretty expensive, and as prices go up, it gets more and more expensive. So, right from the early days in the 19th century, people realized this was an issue and tried to make harmonicas with individual single reeds, either the reed itself or the reed on a mini reed plate, single reed plate. And there have been quite a few attempts over the years. Probably the most interesting one, in my opinion, was the U.S. Army Band harmonica, which was made by the Harmonic Reed Corporation of Philadelphia in about the 1940s, 1950s. And it's a really cool design. But unfortunately, it was a bit leaky, and it never really managed to compete on sound, with traditional harmonicas. And it sort of, ended up not being successful in the market. Ever since I started playing back in the 1980s in New Zealand, I've had the same idea, and I'm sure lots of other people have. In fact, it comes up regularly on chat groups. Why do we have to, buy a whole new harmonica? Why can't we just replace single reeds? It's a perennial question. So anyway, I've had this idea for a long time as well, and tried hacking harmonicas back in those days with hacks, literally with hacksaws. And it's been in my mind ever since, over through the decades. In recent years, I think I've sort of found a really good way to overcome the issues of previous harmonicas with single reeds. And I've now come up with my own version of what I call the Modular-Reed Harmonica. It contains a few innovations which I think make the Modular-Reed Harmonica much more of a viable prospect, more playable, easier for anyone to swap reeds in and out, and also using existing components. And I've taken out a patent in China for this for my design, and also a USPTO provisional patent for it. So I'd like now to explain a little bit, what these innovations are. But first of all, let me play you the sounds of two Richter harmonicas in C. This one is the Kongsheng Amazing 20 lip comb harmonica, which is a very common, popular lip comb model. And this one here is my modular reed harmonica, which is using the parts from the Kongsheng Amazing 20, but with every reed individual. So here's the Kongsheng and my modular reed harmonica. So I hope you can hear that, to all intents and purposes, they play with identical expression, volume, response. And so let me now show you how my modular reed harmonica is put together. So first of all, here's the Kongsheng Amazing 20. And of course, this is a typical modern diatonic harmonica. It's got a comb, central comb, a couple of cover plates, and your blow reed plate on the top, the blow reeds there, and your draw reed plate on the bottom. So, if a reed breaks, in this case, you would actually probably have to throw away the entire harmonica, or maybe Kongsheng, I'm not sure, do replacement reed plates. But you'd certainly have to replace both reed plates at the very least. Now, the reason I chose the Kongsheng Amazing 20 as the base model for my initial limited release of the modular reed harmonica is because it's got really long comb chambers. You can see the comb chambers are quite long, and this means that I can swap reeds around really easily. You can take a blow reed and move it four chambers to the right, and it'll still work. And this is not the case with many other harmonicas. which have got more restricted cone chambers. So that's one of the main reasons. And using a standard production ABS, injection molded comb is also quite an innovative thing in this whole field of modular reed harmonicas. Basically, all previous designs have had to have custom combs specially made, which is going to introduce a huge amount of cost. My one can use standard existing comb designs. Okay, so here's my modular reed harp. You can see it's got the name on the cover plate and also on the rear of the comb. And this is what it looks like disassembled. So it's exactly the same procedure as with a standard harp. You just remove the cover plates. And instantly you start to see some innovative features. You can see that the cover plates in this case have got these little brace parts. Okay, so this is one of the elements of my patent. These protrude slightly further than the outer tabs of the covers. And that means that when you put the cover plate on, it's lifted up slightly from the comb, just a millimetre or so. And then when you do up the two outer tabs, the pressure holds the modular reeds in place. And as you can see, there they are. They're, instead of having one draw reed plate for all 10 reeds, you've got each reed is on its own mini reed plate. So that's, but still it fits into the same footprint of the this common ABS injection molded lipped comb. And if we turn the harp over, that's the standard harp, and that's my modular reed harmonica. You can see, again, every blow reed is on its own mini reed plate. Well, there they are. They're sitting in there. They're not secured. So how do they stay in there, you might ask? Okay, well, that's another innovation of mine. If you look on this comb here, maybe I'll hold it up to this camera, you can see there's the blue parts on the comb. Okay, those are very thin little gasket parts. And they're a special type of material which has got a differential adhesive. So that means that what the adhesive underneath the gasket, where it sticks down on the comb, is strong, and it's got a weak adhesive on the outside here. And that's got several advantages. For one thing, it really helps the air tightness of the harmonica, because every individual reed has got a gasket around it. So it's just, it's well sealed, which often can't be said for a standard harmonica comb, which has sometimes got little gaps between the reed plates and the comb, unless the things are flat sanded. So this gives you a better seal around each individual reed. And secondly, it holds the reeds in place when you want to do a bit of work on them. But because the actual differential adhesive, the adhesive of the outer surface, is quite weak, it's so easy just to lift the reed off. So you just put something in the back. I've got these little indents in the reed plates. So I'm just using a pair of tweezers here. You could use a toothpick or a mini screwdriver or whatever. You can see I just lifted the reed out. You can see the gasket underneath. And it's very easy to lift out. Then you can just pop the reed back in and it stays in place. So now the harmonica can be tuned up and even played. So I'm just playing that without the cover plates on, but the reeds are staying in place. So that's really handy because it's stops them falling out everywhere, which would be a real issue trying to get them back in place if they fell out all over the floor. This keeps them in place and, as I say, gives them better air sealing. Now, the modular reed harmonica is a chameleon. It can be anything you like. This one happens to be a C harp and Richter because that's, for basically the simplicity of explanation, it's the one I'm just using for this video. But I mean, this particular harmonica could be in any tuning and in any key you like. All you have to do is just swap out the reeds and make it, tune it to how you want. So besides the repair aspect, you can also change the tuning of your harmonica whenever you want. It doesn't have to be just one thing. On my website, we've got two sets of tables. There's a basic table with a drop-down list of common tunings, and you can just pick whatever tuning you want, whatever key you want, and we'll make a modular reed harmonica and send it out to you. And my friend Andre Coelho has done a special video on how to do that. If you want to be more adventurous, you can really go crazy. There's an advanced table there where you can actually do all sorts of mad things, move reeds from the hole 1 to hole 10 or vice versa, and turn them around, flip them over, put them on this side. And there's another video all about how to use the advanced options. But for now, I'm just going to talk about some very small changes you can make to a standard Richter harp, just to kind of give you the idea of what's possible. Now, you can buy just the single harmonica with the 10 single reeds, but you can also buy this little tray. It's either a 5-reed tray or a 10-reed tray. And what this does is you can actually buy a selection of extra reeds to go into your modular reed harmonica. Now, this could be for repair. For instance, on most standard harps, the 5-draw is one that players often blow out because they try and bend it. You know, like you can bend 4-draw, but you can't bend 5-draw. But people try to. You know, they really try and wail on that 5-draw, and unfortunately the poor little thing just gives up the ghost. And the 5-draw goes, then you have to throw away your harmonica. No longer, you don't have to do that. Let me just demonstrate. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's hole 5. So there's your 5-draw. Just say it's, you know, it's kaput. So now you just go into your, if you selected a 5-draw for your harp in and put it in the reed tray, you just get the reed out, swap it in there, and now you've got that 5-draw. So you've got it, you've now got a working harp just by replacing one reed. So that's just, you know, a game changer, you know, so easy. Anyone can do it, as you can see. Now, the other thing you might want to do is possibly change your standard Richter harp into a country-tuned harp. So, for example, you might want to order another reed, which is a semitone higher than 5-draw. On a C harp, it would be an F-sharp draw note. Okay, so there's your 5-draw slot. So now, here's the sound with the standard 5-draw, which you sort of heard, which is great for second position blues. But say you want a kind of a different flavor, more of a sweet flavor, which you can often get that from, you can get that from country tuning. It's a great alternate tuning that's quite widely used. So we just go to the harmonica, pull out the 5-draw, and swap in another 5-draw, which is a semitone higher. And this will give the harmonica a totally different flavor. Suddenly it's in country tuning. So now it's you've got a major scale in second position. Plus you can play in third position in major. And you've got an extra bend, an extra draw bend in the harp. Okay, so that's a really easy and small change you can make to your harp with the modular reed harmonica, which on a normal harmonica, you have to get in there and, you know, you have to file up the reed. And once you file up the reed, it can't be a normal harmonica unless you file it down again or put some blue tack on the end or whatever. So it's a lot more of a faff to change a standard harp into country tuning. And, you know, probably 90% of players don't have the skills or couldn't be bothered. Now with the modular reed harmonica, anyone can change that and, you know, try out country tuning. Okay, so the harp's back now to its original configuration. So what's let's check out a couple of other options. 4-draw is another reed that you know, players often blow out. So again, if your harp 4-draw is gone, you can just swap in another 4-draw note from your rack, and there you go. So there we go. So that's another good repair option if you're playing Richter harp and you just want to keep your harp going and you can predict what reeds you're going to break. You could probably buy 3 5-draws and a couple of 4-draws and, you know, your harp will go on indefinitely. So that's the repair side. But just getting back to alternate tunings, another popular alternate tuning, one I came up with, is called Paddy Richter. So now we turn the harp over, and now we can see the blow reeds there. So the reed that you want to change for Paddy Richter is 3-blow. That needs to go up a tone. So as you know, on a normal harp, 2-draw and 3-blow are the same note, okay? So in order to get this note, you have to bend three draw down a full tone. And that's really nice for slow music. But for fast tunes, especially say Irish tunes or fiddle tunes in general, it's much easier to have that note built in. So Paddy Richter gives you that note built in. You don't have to bend it. And on the modular reed harmonica, it's so easy to create that tuning. So here we go. So here's your three blow note. So you can remove that. And now we're going to swap in another three blow note. And we're going to turn the harp into Paddy Richter. It's that quick, just like that. Okay, so suddenly the harp's in Paddy Richter, just like that. So it's so easy for anyone to do. No, you know, fancy skills involved. I'll put that back to Richter again. Now, another popular tuning is to turn your harp into natural minor for second position. So that involves taking this note, three draw, and dropping it a semitone down to that note, which you normally have to bend to. But having it built in can give you some really good, a natural minor flavor without having to bend notes in second position. So, how do you do that? So it's the draw note, it's draw three that we've got to drop a semitone. Now check this out, this is one of the possibilities that you can explore once you get into the more wild, crazy aspects of the modular reed harmonica. Draw reeds in most modern harmonicas are mounted at the rear. So that's what a draw reed normally looks like, and that's what a blow reed normally looks like. But in reality, there's no such thing as an intrinsically blow reed or draw reed. What defines the reeds as blow or draw is their position on the reed plate. So let me just show you what I mean. So here's our three blow reed and three draw reed. Now, if I want to turn the blow reed into a draw reed, I can. I just get my three blow reed, turn it over, suddenly it's a draw reed. So now if I draw on that hole, I've got one draw reed there, one draw reed there, I'm going to get two reeds playing a chord. Okay, they're not perfectly in tune, but they can be tuned up to make them in tune. So now you understand that concept. Let me just show you how you can change your normal Richter tuned harp into a natural minor. So it's that three draw that we're going to change. So there it is, three draw. So we just pull that one out. And I'm going to get another reed here. Now this one is a front mounted reed, and normally this would be a blow reed. Okay, it would be looking like that. Mounted at the front, you can see, here's another example, if I pull that one out. So there's a front mounted blow reed, and it just goes in like that. And that's the function that this one would normally be playing, this blow reed. But it's not really a blow reed per se, because if we just put it up, put it on the bottom of the harmonica like that, it's now going to be acting as a draw reed. Now you can see it looks a little bit different to the other draw reeds there, because the actual reed direction is different, but that's immaterial. It'll still act as a draw reed. And so now we should have a natural minor harp. Okay, so bang, that's so easy. You've got a natural minor harp, within seconds and without any special skills. So if I put this reed back in again, the harp will return to Richter, and it's now playing as normal. And you can put this reed away in your little reed case. So it's back in the reed case, and then the top just stays on with magnets, so it's really easy to keep them safe, but also to get at the reeds when you need them. The main thing to remember when putting reeds in and out of the modular reed harmonica is that they can be on the bottom of the comb, the top of the comb, they can be flipped over one way or the other, but they almost always must be placed front to back in the same way. And that's partly why we've got all these indents on the base of the reeds there. So I've actually done two batches of slicing reeds, and you can see this harmonica has got some reeds with the with one kind of indent and another with a different kind of indent. They're the same brand of reed and whatever, they'll fit interchangeably, but that little indent will it just looks a little bit different. So don't be put off if your harmonica comes with all the this kind of indent as opposed to that one. So, but they still will pull out with, you know, using a toothpick or tweezers or whatever, small screwdriver. Okay, so once you've selected your reeds and you're happy with what you're going to be playing, the next step is just to put the cover plates back on, and that's very simple. So you just get your upper and lower cover plates as normal. The lower cover plate goes over the draw reeds, and the upper cover plate goes over the blow reeds. You just sort of hold them in place with your fingers. And then you insert the female screw into the lower cover plate and the male screw into the upper cover plate. Can be a little bit fiddly, but just get them in there. And then just do a few turns, but don't tighten them up all the way. Then you get your other female screw and hold that in place. And then another male screw, drop that into the hole. And again, just do it up a few turns, but don't do it up all the way. At this point, just move the cover plates around until you can feel that they're definitely behind that front lip of the comb. And then you can screw them up tightly. And when you do that, the internal pressure brace will press down on the insides of the reed plates and press down hard, and they'll push down on the gasket and onto the comb, and the whole thing will sound really nice and airtight. So once they're on, you can pick up your harp and just play as normal. Well, I hope this introductory video on my modular reed harmonica gives you a good overall idea of the possibilities. There's actually way more than I've covered here, and for the adventurous, the experimental ones amongst you, there's a whole wild frontier of amazing possibilities, which I'll cover in another video, talking about the advanced reed selector. But if you just want a harp which you can replace reeds when they break, the modular reed harmonica does the job. Now, in order to test the market and also just test our systems, because it's a surprisingly complicated harmonica to the systems around it are pretty complicated. We've got racks and racks of reeds, and we have to be able to find the right reed. And my website guru, David Ireland, has done a brilliant job on creating amazing selection tables. But you wouldn't believe the complexity that's involved behind the scenes with this harmonica, even though the actual harmonica is quite a simple thing in itself. Anyway, if you don't want to worry about all the complex side of it, you can just go onto the website, pick a tuning, pick a key, and bang, we'll make the harmonica and send it out to you. But as I say, if you do want to go crazy with all sorts of experimentation, but didn't know how to replace reeds and all the rest of it, and sort of gave up at that point, my modular reed harmonica now makes it super simple for anyone to mess around and try out different tunings. So I hope this has been useful to you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.